In the last episode, we already talked about how we could generate artificial gravity for a crude version of Starship, how we could protect Starship from cosmic rays, and how we could cut down the travel time to Mars. We will put the links to these videos in the description.
Today we want to talk about another extremely important issue of long journeys to Mars, namely the maximum crew complement. Elon often said that the Starship would allow for 100 people to travel to Mars. Can this number actually really be achieved, or will Starship have to make do with a lower crew complement? Well, let's find out!
When Elon first revealed the vessel which would take humanity to Mars back in 2016, we were presented the giant behemoth ITS, the Interplanetary Transport System. It was really large, with a diameter of 12 meters and roughly the same length as the current Starship design. Back then, Elon said that the ITS would be able to transport 100 people to Mars at once. A number which seemed credible, since that monster would have had an interior pressurized volume of more than 2,000 cubic meters. 100 people in a 2,000 cubic meter volume seems a bit cramped, but it's still possible. For example, we could have had 4 crew quarter decks, with 25 cabins on each deck. Each cabin could have had a footprint of 4 square meters and a ceiling height of 2.5 meters, so in total 10 cubic meters of private space per passenger. However, we all know that in 2017, Elon announced the next iteration of the Mars transport infrastructure, which was named BFR. The diameter of the upper section then decreased to 9 meters, so only 75% of the ITS diameter, since the interior volume of a cylinder is proportional to the radius squared. This means that the interior volume of Starship has significantly shrunk from 2,000 cubic meters down to only 1,000, which is of course still more than the entire ISS, yet only half as much as initially planned. Interestingly though, the number of people to be transported to Mars in one go remains at 100. So wait, the internal pressurized living space of Starship has halved, yet the number of the passengers stays the same. This means that on average, one person would only have 10 cubic meters of space, down from the 20 cubic meters as in the ITS. This is considering the space of the whole ship, not only the private cabins. So psychologically speaking, would this even be possible? To have so many people cramped in such a small volume on a 6-month trip to Mars, where there's no possibility of escape and no turning back midway. Surrounded by the same people for 6 months in such a small volume. Let's analyze what psychology has to say to that.
Intriguingly, NASA already conducted some studies on this very topic. The Subject Matter Expert Consensus Session Report for the Human Research Program, HRP, titled Minimum Acceptable Net Habitable Volume for Long Duration Exploration Missions from 2014, gonna love these short and concise NASA headlines, comes to the conclusion that 25 cubic meters per person would be the minimum acceptable net habitable volume, which they call NHV. Link, of course, in the description. They looked at a standard habitat module as would have been employed on a NASA mission to Mars with an interior volume of 150 cubic meters. It is divided into private quarters or personal sleeping space, dining and communal activity space, workspace, an exercise area, common hygiene facilities, translation portals or pass-throughs, and stowage access. They based their estimate on prior research on board of space stations Skylab, Mir and the ISS and took into account psychological studies in order to arrive at that number. In another NASA study from 2011, link also in the description, they concluded that the minimum acceptable net habitation volume follows a logarithmic function. So first it rises steeply with the mission duration, but later on flattens and then rises only slowly. A trip to Mars with Starship would normally take around 6 months. Yes, we sometimes hear that 3 months might be possible, but we still doubt that number. So 180 days, according to this chart, would mean about 20 to 22 cubic meters of NHV, quite in line with the 25 cubic meters from the more recent NASA study. Okay, so the NHV probably will be anywhere between 20 and 25 cubic meters. This would mean for Starship that a crew complement of 100 persons is quite unrealistic, since in that scenario each person would only have 10 cubic meters of space. For the NHV that NASA suggests, we would then get a maximum crew complement of 40, maximum 50 persons. And this doesn't take into account how much cargo, drinking water, food and so on would have to also be transported to Mars. Because 100 people would require also twice the amount of food and water than 50 people, which would of course decrease the payload of what could be transported to Mars along with the colonists.
Now, some people say that we are too conservative. We should look at submarines for comparisons. We think that this comparison might sound logical on the surface, but it actually isn't an adequate comparison. A submarine which would be close in crew complement to Starship would be a Seawolf class submarine with a crew complement of 140. It has a length of 108 meters and a beam width of 12 meters. So if we approximate the submarine as a cylinder, we would get an interior volume of around 12,000 cubic meters. But of course, we have torpedo bays, machine room, power generation, and so on. So quite a lot of unusable space. According to some interior schematics, a bit less than half of the submarine's interior volume can be used by its crew. So let's be super conservative and say 4,500 cubic meters. This would result in 32 cubic meters of space per crew member, quite a lot higher than the NHV of 20 to 25 cubic meters suggested by NASA. However, in Elon's 100 people per Starship configuration, each crew member would only have approximately 10 cubic meters of space, as we already calculated. So around 3 times less than in a submarine. And our interior volume estimate of the submarine was really conservative. So the difference factor would probably be even higher in reality. We should not forget the different psychology either. In a submarine, you are days, maximum a week, from the nearest harbor. So in case something goes wrong, for example, some crew members become sick and need medical treatment, the submarine could just turn around and reach a harbor quite fast. On a trip to Mars with Starship, you don't have this possibility. All crew members would know that you cannot turn Starship around on a trip to Mars. Once on the way to Mars, it's on the way with no possibility of turning back midway. This is an important psychological factor. So in our opinion, 25 cubic meters of space per passenger would be the minimum number for trips to Mars. Maybe even 30 cubic meters to be on the safe side.
Now, the only scenario where we could actually imagine 100 people in a 1,000 cubic meter volume on a trip to Mars as offered by the current Starship design would be if travel time was a maximum of 3 months in combination with Neuralink VR. What? Neuralink VR? Yes, that would basically mean that Starship would employ the latest Neuralink technology in order to send visual feed directly into the brain, thus creating super realistic holodeck simulations. People could then spend quite a few hours per day linked into the Neuralink in virtual holodeck spaces in order to escape the claustrophobic confinement of Starship. But we have to say that we are not entirely sure if Neuralink will be ready to offer such immersive and realistic experiences until the first crews are sent to Mars with Starship. We hope yes. However, if not, and also if we aren't able to reach Mars in 3 months, but it would take 6 months, then we only see the option of reducing the crew complement to a maximum of 40 people per trip. Now, later iterations of Starship, of course, such as the often speculated gigantic Starship 2.0, which Elon mentioned would have a diameter of 18 meters, would of course drastically increase the maximum crew complement. But let's assume now a realistic scenario. A Starship as we know it, so 9 meters of diameter, 50 meters height, and 1,000 cubic meters of interior volume. Of course, we highly recommend to rotate Starship in some form and shield against cosmic rays as discussed in our previous videos, because that is doable without a lot of additional modifications, contrary to faster transit times, which would probably require a completely new propulsion system. So how could the interior Starship then look for a crew complement of 40 people for a 40 crew strong Mars colony Starship en route to Mars? We found some excellent renders which show how the crew sections could be possibly arranged. We found this one here from Starship Renders highly realistic. It shows 4 crew compartment decks with 8 cabins per deck, so 32 cabins in total. Therefore, this configuration could then consequently host a crew of 32 people. We estimate that in this design here, one cabin would have around 4 square meters of living space, so that would suffice for one person. Other renders we found are more on the, we would say, unrealistic side. This is how it would look to cram 100 people into Starship. In our opinion, this is absolutely not advisable, except of course, as mentioned, with sophisticated Neuralink holodeck simulations. SpaceX's own rendering is not really precise. It would indicate 3 crew compartment decks with around 10 cabins each, so 30 cabins in total, leading to a crew size of 30 people.
Here are some other really excellent ones by Michel Lamontagne. He suggests 2 crew quarter decks with 8 cabins per deck, yielding a total of 16 cabins. Therefore, we believe this is intended for 16 people per Starship. Now, while of course this variant would offer a luxurious 62.5 cubic meters per person, we think that this might even be too much space per person, even though we totally love the design, and especially the Rebel X-Wing pilot sitting on the toilet. But yes, you get the picture. There are so many possible arrangements for a crewed version of Starship, and we cannot wait to learn how SpaceX will design the interior of Starship for trips to Mars, and how many cabins and what kind of crew complement Starship will have. We suggest between 30 and 40 people for the current iteration of Starship for trips to Mars, as this might be the best trade-off between get as many people as possible to Mars in one go and not risking people to go insane or to have brutal psychological disorders on the trip. We really don't want our future colonists to arrive on Mars as mental wrecks, but in good shape, both psychologically and physically.
So what do you think will be the maximum crew complement of Starship? 30 people or maybe even 40?
Or do you agree with Elon that 100 would even be possible? Be sure to tell us your opinion in the comment section.
So you just watched the Friday's JS Space report, in which we talk about fixing the flaws of Starship for a safe travel to Mars, and you can watch the other videos about that topic right here.
So thanks for watching, and I'd say, on to the future!